Yo, 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 guess what? You guys have made it inside of my motor coach, baby. We are in here. So this is the entry part of my motor coach. This part serves so many different purposes. So we're going to go ahead and get started. And I'm going to start off with this armoire piece right here as soon as you walk in. This serves multiple different purposes. So let me just show you all around. This is the entry level, baby. Alright, so when you open up this armoire piece, it serves multiple different purposes, alright? So basically, I keep a couple of coats here, some hoodies in here. I also have a washer and spin dryer. I keep a extra table back here. Down here, I keep some files and fax machine, copier, printer. All of that good stuff. I also throw my gym bag down in here. And this particular thing actually serves a great purpose because it also doubles as a office area as well too. So I do have a pull-out office with a computer in the back. I'll show you guys. And now this chair right here serves multiple different purposes as well. So this chair I can obviously use for my computer or office work as well too. I can also turn this chair around completely and it lounge all the way back. And I can utilize this TV here, which is what I use when I'm in travel mode, when my slides are closed, so I don't have to use my main TV. And I can just relax right here and take a quick break. And I also have this right here, which is a shoebox that I built. And basically, I put a couple of different shoes in there, so I'll show you guys how to use this. Cabinet, I keep some games. Over here, I keep some movies. I am still a DVD watcher, so sometimes I just want to watch some old DVDs that I can't find on streaming services. I also keep more DVDs over here, DVD player, security camera that keeps an eye on the dog and entry doors. Also have more games up here as well too in this particular cabinet. Yo, yo, we made it to the living room, baby. So let me go ahead and give you guys some advice. If you're going to live tiny, your furniture and your space need to be able to serve multiple different functionalities, right? So in my living room, I'm going to show you guys how my living room serves multiple different functionalities for me. So introducing my living room. Start off with the couch. So remember how I said that every furniture need to have multiple different functionalities, right? So what I did was I wanted a smaller couch. However, I still wanted to have the functionality on if I had a guest sleep over, how could this work out, right? So what I did was I did a couch with no arms. And I had this chair. So what you do is if I turn this chair this way, then it becomes a sleeping area for one person. The head usually go there and they can stretch out and it's totally fine. If they're over, 6'4", then guess what? I guess I got to move the table and their legs are going to be hanging off. But all right. So right here, I have my little table, books, some candles. I usually keep my remotes right here. Back here in this little space back here, hidden is a third air conditioner unit. If you know anything about living in a motor coach or living in a tiny home in like a class A motorhome, it gets hot in the summertime. And until I install a third roof unit, I have a portable AC unit that vents out of this window here, and that gives me a third AC space. This is just some wall art back here. It's just sitting there, but you can actually take it down. There's a window behind it. I didn't want curtains just all over, so I decided to make a little wall art, and I can pull it down. It has some power windows. They roll up, and I still enjoy the view. All right. This is my chair. I always sit here. Everybody knows you come to my house, it's my chair. You don't sit here, you sit over there. I have my curtains back here, and I have this extra space right here. Now, this extra dresser right here, it just serves as multiple different things. So I think everybody has a junk drawer. So this is like my, technically my junk drawer down here. I have a couple of things in here. You know, just extra space if I need it, whatever. Full length floor to ceiling mirror. Everybody needs that mirror when they're getting dressed. And yeah, this is my living room area. So my driver chair spins around. That makes additional living space. If I have additional guests, someone can sit here. Of course, here's the TV, fireplace down below. And I have a floating mantle. Now, on top of my floating mantle, I actually had a sound bar. The sound bar was such an eyesore. So what I did was I actually put the sound bar inside of the mantle. So you'll hear the surround sound coming through here and around the seating area as well. And then here I have a little piece of art, and that is basically covering the side of a wine fridge, which I'll basically show you in a second. And here is my vinyl player, which I actually play some vinyl records. And it also has Bluetooth capabilities as well, too. So that's normally how I get my jam on earlier. So basically, this is my living room. So now I want to show you guys just how my living room functions and serve multiple different purposes. All I have to do is just snap my finger, and then it's like, now I have a full workout bench and a treadmill. So if I'm unable to go to the gym, I can still get my workout on right in my home. And boom, baby, we're back. So they say behind every great man, there's a great woman. That's what they say. But what I can tell you is behind every great piece of furniture, there's a great weight bench, because that's where it's at, behind the furniture. So that I can definitely confirm. But that's my living room, and it serves multiple different functionalities, and it works for me. All right, y'all, so we done made it to my kitchen. This is actually one of the biggest transformations that I made here in the Motorcoach. Take a look at some of these before pictures. All right, so that was before. Take a look and see where we have gotten. Here's my kitchen. So here we are in my kitchen. All right, so this right here is actually a wine fridge, but what I did was I just used it as a drink fridge. Usually holds my sodas, waters, juices. I also put like fruits and vegetables in here sometime as well too, because if you know anything about the Dometic fridge for RVs, sometimes they freeze and I don't want my lettuce to freeze, so sometimes I normally put it in here. But that's my wine fridge. I added a dishwasher, a little portable dishwasher. It's very small, but yeah, needed a dishwasher. I usually keep my wine here. And on the back side of my TV wall, I added a wine bar. So I added wine. I have a wine chiller back here, wine opener. Behind that is my ice maker. Right over here, I keep my eggs, sugars, other little things like that, my teas, coffee maker, like coffee filters. In this cabinet here is my actual coffee maker. That's back there. I usually keep like snacks in here, cookies, things like that. In here, I keep this prepared for driving. So in here, I have some bowls, my plates. I normally stack my glasses and stuff in here. But this is all of my kitchenware that I normally use. Microwave. And in here I have a oven, toaster combo. So I keep that in here, keep my air fryer down here. When I'm plugged in, I usually use my electric hot plate. When I'm somewhere where I'm not plugged in, that's when I actually flip this up and I'll use my propane stove, propane oven. What else I got over here? This is my knives and forks and spoons and all that good stuff. In here, I just keep some, you know, oven mitts, other utensils. Down here, keep pots and pans. So let me explain this. So this right here, what I try to do is I try not to use water in my tank for nothing besides showering, basically. So I try to use that just for shower, because one thing, there's a almost kind of like a little idea that people that live in RVs don't shower. I shower daily, multiple times. So what I do is I try to make sure that I keep water in my tank just for showering. So I usually use this right here if I'm just washing some quick dishes. You know, I'll have this here. And let's see here. What else I got in here? This is like my little spice drawer. A little salt, pepper, sugar, all of that good stuff right here. I don't know why I give this little lamp right here, but I got the lamp right here. When I my little drying rack, trash can. Now, over on this side of the coach, I actually have this little piece of cabinet right here, but this is extra pantry space. So I usually keep some extra stuff down here because this is the only pantry space that I have in here, which is basically pretty small. I want to redo this thing eventually, but it's actually pretty small. So I only can store so much things in here. So that extra piece of furniture down there comes in clutch. Down here, I keep, like, you know, plastic wrap, foil paper, trash bags. And here is my fridge. I ain't got no food up in there. I'm kind of low. I usually keep my fresh water in here. Apple pies, stuff like that. But like I said, with this refrigerator here, it freezes sometime if I don't go in there too long. So that's why I keep my lettuce and things in. See, look all this smoke. Freezing. And this is my freezer, basically. Now, in this part of the kitchen, I actually have a frame right here, a picture frame right here. But this is to hide all of these control panels. So I got lights back here, my AC thermostat, my fresh water tank buttons, turn on my generator from here, control my slides, my solar panel equipment is back here, my solar circuit breakers. Yeah, so there's a lot of stuff that's back here, and I was tired looking at it, so I just actually put that frame there to actually cover it up. It looks so much better. But yeah, but this is the kitchen, baby. This is it. Now we have made it to my bathroom. Now look, don't get me wrong, it's pretty small. However, it definitely does everything it needs to do and more. Because like I said, every small space needs multiple functionalities. So I'm going to show you just how my bathroom functions in several different ways. So this is the bathroom. I keep my hand towels here. What is in there? Cotton balls, Q-tips, hand soap. These things here, if you see, it's like it might wobble a little bit, but it's Velcro down. It doesn't go anywhere. Like I drive with it like that. It stays there. See what's in here. Got the mouthwash, hand lotion, face wash, gel, deodorant, alcohol. Nothing fancy in here. Just regular bathroom stuff. Here's my shower. And in my shower, I have a mat surrounded by some rocks, my loofah, shampoo, conditioner, body oils, all of that good stuff, shower head. Let's see, down here, I have extra supplies, extra bedroom stuff, you know. And if you see this down here, this is actually a 2.5 gallon container. And I use that container and it has fresh water in there. Because remember I told you guys that I don't like to use my shower. I'm sorry, my tank for nothing besides my shower, right? So what I do is I actually take my mug and I use fresh water instead of using water out of the tank. And this is to either wash my face, brush my teeth. I use water from here, brush my teeth and just, you know, spit it out and put my cup back. So I rather use fresh water than water that's in that holding tank. So the holding tank is literally just for shower and, you know, regular stuff. But I try to use it mostly for my shower. And it lasts a pretty long time. Like, I can pretty much get by, like, almost a month without having to refill. I got my little, extra little accessories there. Mirrors behind here. This is where I hang my robe. Right, and behind this door here is basically the water closet. So first thing on this side is my ironing board that just drops down. I can iron. This thing here serves multiple different purposes. That's what I told you. In small spaces, it has to be functional in multiple different ways. So here I keep, like, you know, extra towels, and I also keep extra shoes in here as well too, since I have so many shoes. I just kind of keep my shoes in here or whatnot. These thing right here, like, you see this here, this, like, I can drive with this like this. It's like, it's definitely there. It doesn't move. It definitely doesn't move. The toilet here on this side, I keep my vacuum, broom, mop, extra towels here as well. And up here, my iron, steamer, trash bags. And this little thing right here is my little cocktail that I make for my toilet. So I just put it in here so I can just kind of pull it out and then just press the button and it falls down right into the toilet. I like me a fresh toilet and I like my toilet to smell good. So yeah, but that is my bathroom. Multiple functions. And yeah, it's small, but it does the job. All right, y'all. So we done made it to the last section of the motor coach, which is my bedroom. So this is where I get my peace, my sleep, my joy. Oh my God, I really like my bedroom. It's so cozy up in here. And I have it, like, blacked out so I can sleep in late if I want to. I can also brighten it up if I need to, if I want to wake up early. But here goes my bedroom. So we enter the bedroom. So I wanted my bedroom to feel like almost like I was in, like, a boutique, right? So that's why I hung out all of my, you know, fancy stuff, like my little thunder jackets and stuff, book bag. Keep my fan over there because I don't like to be hot. Over on this side, I keep my hamper for my dirty clothes. It's right there. On this side over here, floor to ceiling and mirror. I keep some shoes here. You know, throw some bags there as well to hang out my little scarves. Over on this side is my closet. So yeah, it's closet space right there. Got some more shoes here. I cut out one of these drawers or two of the drawers here to actually make some more shoe space down at the bottom. Keep my watches here, some jewelry there. TV's right here, and in this cabinet right here, like I said, in the front I have the washer, but back here I keep the heated dryer and, you know, dryer supplies and little stuff like that. But yeah, this is my bedroom. I absolutely love it. It's my piece. It feels like a little boutique back here. I love my bedroom. All right, y'all, so this concludes my interior tour. I really appreciate you guys for watching. But if you stuck around this long, go ahead and support my channel. Hit that subscribe button. Like, comment. If you need advice, if you got questions, feel free to reach out to me. I'll definitely reply. But again, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you like it. And until next time, peace.